Now let's look at the expression for indicated work for a single acting compressor. So this is the PV plot we did when we were discussing about the construction of a single acting reciprocating air compressor. So we'll further that discussion and we'll draw the same PV plot again. Okay, so you have line C1 indicating the suction stroke, then line 1-2 and then 2D as your delivery and 1-2 as your compression. Okay. Now this is the polytropic compression, so you have PV to the power n is equal to constant, right? So there you have three areas basically. The work below this plot gives you the work done. So you have three areas. The first area I'll shade in blue. This is the first area that we'll have to consider. The second area, let me take it in red. So this is the second area. And the third area that we'll be taking, let me take that in black. So this is the third area. Okay, so the total indicated work W in, this is equal to the sum of this area and minus this area. So let's have a look at that. So this area, first of all, let's have a look at this much area. This area. So this is area 2D 0 B, this is B, this is B, and then 2 back. So this area, this complete area, this entire area, this is what we have taken. This is the area. Okay. So what is this area? This area is the flow work during the delivery stroke. So we'll come to that. Okay. Then you have to add the area which is 1, 2, B, A, 1. So you'll have area 1, 2, B, A, 1. Now what is this area? This is the work done during this polytropic compression. Okay. And then you'll have to subtract the bottom area, which is C1A0C. So area C1A0C. Okay. So let me designate these areas as this is area 1, this is area 2, and this is area 3. So area 1, let's talk about area 1. Area 1. Area 1 is the flow work during the discharge stroke. And that flow work is nothing but P2V2. Okay. What about area 2? Area 2. Now area 2 would be a negative displacement work because compression is being is taking place from pressure P1 to pressure P2. So this would be minus PdV. Okay. Now because it's a polytropic compression, the value would become P2 V2 minus P1 V1 upon n minus 1, where n is the polytropic index. Now let's come to area 3, which we need to subtract. Area 3. So this is being subtracted because this is the pumping work. Okay, suction work. So this is again flow work, P1, V1. This is during the suction stroke. So when you put in these values over here, this becomes P2, V2 plus P2, V2 minus P1, V1 upon n minus 1 minus P1, V1. So this is the mathematical expression to find out the indicated work for a single acting compressor. That is, you need to add area 1 and area 2 and subtract area 3 from their sum. So that would give you the net space as this. So this is the net space that you'll get. This much. This is the net space which will give you the indicated work for this particular compressor. Okay, so I hope you understood the calculation for the indicated work Now let's move on to the next video and talk about the mean effective pressure.